All right, so let's continue with this. This time we are going to create the deformation with a sine wave. And to do that, it's actually really simple to do. We can use, again, a sine function. But this time, instead of feeding this sine wave with time, what we can do is use, for example, the warp position of this fish, create our deformation, and then put all that back to the warp position offset, right? So for example, in this case, what I can do is use the z-axis position, the x-axis position, sorry, to feed my sine wave, right? That means that every single centimeter in this direction is going to create a full revolution in this function, right? To do that, let's create a duplicate from the warp position. Let's mask the component we are interested on, which is x, right? So, like I said before, every single centimeter in this direction will generate a revolution. If you connect this thing, maybe you will see something funny happening, maybe kind of noise, I guess. But you will see that it's kind of working, right? It's just creating that deformation across that axis. Well, obviously, right now it's acting across the three axes. So I guess the first thing that we want to do is clamp those. So for that, we can use the same trick with this for the lateral movement. I just want this to work in the deformation to work in the y axis. And there you go. Now it's only working in this direction. But now we need to add controls. We need to control, I guess at this point we can use real terms. Let me just explain that. When you have a sine wave, right, something like that, I guess, the distance between this point and this point is called amplitude, right? And the distance between this point and this point is called frequency. So at this point, the frequency will go along this axis. And the amplitude will go along this, I guess let me just choose the right color, across that axis, right? So let's do that. First we need to create the controls for the amplitude. For that, that's pretty easy. After isolating the y-axis, what you can do is simply multiply. We know that this sign, it's minus 1 to 1, so if we multiply this thing by something, let's call this thing amplitude, like so. If you multiply one to minus 1 to for 100, that means that the amplitude is going to be 1 meter. Right? So let me just connect this thing so we can see it. There you go. yeah, but now you have a control for the amplitude, right? So you decide how far you need to deform your sine wave. Now let's control the frequency, and for that it's pretty easy to. So we know that those are centimeters, right? So what we can do is basically create a scale of that value before feeding, right, our sine function. And the easiest way to do that is simply make a division. So for example, when you divide those by, let's call this thing frequency, by let's say 100, that means that the first 100 centimeter will become the first unit, right? And the first unit translated to for this sine wave, it will become the first revolution, right? So let's connect those so we can see what's going on. There you go. And now you have a control for the frequency too, right? And remember what I told you before, this thing is exact. So for example here, when you have 100 centimeters, and I guess let me just draw a cube here. Let me just reset this. And then let me just put it right there. This. So when you have 100 centimeters, that means that your frequency, all right, the point, the distance from this point basically matches my 100 centimeter cube, right? So that's pretty cool. So you have full control. And now, what I want to do is simply add the animation, right? Because right now it's static, all this. It's not acting through time. And the easiest way to do that is just simply add an offset to this warp position. So, for example, if you move your fish in that axis, you see that basically it's kind of doing that animation, right? But of course, you don't want to do that in the viewport. You want to do that from within the material. So, what you want to do is just create an offset, and for that, remember the way we create offset, we add or subtract numbers. Basically, that's the thing that's happening here, right? You are subtracting minus 70. So you do exactly the same here. So right after your division, right, you can add or subtract number depending of the direction that you want to take. And then you will input that offset. In this case, we will half or time drive that offset, right? So for example here, if that centimeter, let's say it was 1, right, divided by 100 is going to be like 0.01 plus whatever time you input, it basically causes that animation. See? And now you will see that it's working. Maybe you need to play with the controllers here. So let me play with the frequency first. So my fish is kind of really big, so around 2 meters. So I guess you can feed your own pack for a while with this guy. So yeah, so maybe you want your frequency to happen every 2 meters, right? Something like that. And well, I guess the amplitude is fine, right? So now that we have that movement, I want to add like a second set that will work instead of working in Y like this one. I want a second movement that will work in Z. And for that, we have almost everything done. What we need to do, for example, here is make a duplicate. Let me just reconnect this into my add. And this time, instead of isolating the movement in the Y axis, I want to isolate that in the blue channel, which is the Z axis, right? And I guess this time I want to have more controls. So let me just create new controls for this frequency. Set axis, here you go, and amplitude, set axis. So if I connect this again to warp position offset, you will see that now instead of moving in across Y, it will do the deformation across Z. There you go again. You need to play with the controller, so let me control the amplitude here, maybe not that much, maybe just 10 centimeters, something like that, right? So okay, that's all for this tutorial. In the last tutorial, we will add all those together, right? And then we will finalize this material.